Hi students, again the doubt solving sessions, we continue. We have solved many doubts so far and some more. Almost we are moving towards the finishing of our doubts out of around 450 questions that you solved for this topic. Let us see. What would be the final product when 1-bromo-3-chloro-cyclobutane reacts with 2 equivalents of Na? Are you able to recollect which reaction is this with metallic sodium? Soch sakte ho? Ek second mein aana chahiye? Yes, Wurtz reaction. Wurtz reaction is very simple. If you take 2 equivalent of Na, 2 atoms of sodium and treat it with 1, मान लेते ये पहला कार्बन है 1, 2, 3 पे क्लोरो 1-bromo-3-chloro साइक्लोब्यूटेन तो क्या मिलेगा? सीधी बात है, यहां से ये कट होगा, यहां से ये वाला बॉन्ड टूटेगा, यहां दो वैलेंसी क्रिएट हुए. अभी ऐसा तो बॉन्ड बनेगा नहीं ना. सपोज साइक्लोब्यूटेन है, ये साइक्लोब्यूटेन, अभी यहां से यहां ऐसा बॉन्ड तो नहीं बनेगा ना कार्टून जैसा. ये बॉन्ड अंदर को बन जाएगा लाइक दिस. तो ये एक बाइसाइक्लो कंपाउंड में कन्वर्ट हो गया. इसका नाम भी लिख सकते हैं बाइसाइक्लो. इधर एक कार्बन है, इधर एक है, इस पे जीरो है ब्रिज में. सो 0-1-1-butane. So this is the compound we get, bicyclo 0-1-1-butane. Next this. What is the major product when this molecule, I'm just making that molecule, okay, when this molecule CH2 Br CH3 reacts with NaOC2H5. Let me just check the question which you gave over here. Have they given any other condition above that? You can also check in the book. You must be having the book with you right now. Okay. Only this is not there. This is directly like this. That's what I was thinking. There has to be one CH2 only. And here there is a Br. Okay, so we've just taken the correct question. There was some mistake in the book. Okay, now here. This is the molecule. When I react with NaOC2H5, obviously this bond will undergo fission. So I'll be getting like this. Primary carbocation. And one more, CH3 is there, right? Now, as we know that secondary carbocation is more stable than primary. So, this will undergo ring expansion. You can see ye CH2 idhar aa gaya, ring expand ho gaya, and you get a CH3 over here. So that is how the molecule undergoes expansion of the ring. Correct? अभी सोचना ये है, ये ring expand हो गया. There is expansion of the ring, but at the same time, just think, where is the positive charge gone? Where is this positive? Okay, expansion of ring takes place. One bond is formed. This bond has taken CH2, but what about plus? So plus comes on the secondary carbon. So primary carbocation, which is less stable than secondary, so secondary is formed. Now this plus is there, hydrogen will go from the beta carbon and we'll be getting 1-methylcyclohex-1-ene, correct? Why the expansion of the ring? You can just count and see. This is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, correct? So one, this one gets joined here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Always, whenever like this, a free radical or a carbocation is there directly on the cyclopentane ring, then expansion of ring will take place and it will get converted to more stable cyclohexane form. Now, Ki in acetone. Acetone means this functional group. The functional group is polar. This is electronegative oxygen, electropositive carbon. So, the functional group is polar in nature. That is, it is having a dipole moment. It undergoes SN2 reaction, fine. Meaning right now SN2 is in acetone and acetone is a polar protic or protic? Polar aprotic solvent, correct. Polar aprotic solvent, it can't produce proton. The acetone solvent cannot produce protons, but it is polar because carbonyl hai, ek carbon hai, ek oxygen hai, carbon electropositive hai, oxygen electronegative hai, do charge hai, charge ka distortion, charge ka vibhajan, yehi polarity ya dipole hai. So it is a polar aprotic solvent. Can you guess the name of the reaction? Yay! It is Finkelstein's reaction. Now, understand what will happen. This will break. So, I'll get COCH2 plus. This will break. So, I'll get CH2 plus. This will break. So I'll get CH3 plus. Now who is most stable? Here there is resonance. Here there is resonance. So the one having resonance will be more stable. We have learned resonance will bring stability in the carbocation. This will be more stable, these two, of which this will be still more stable because it is aromatic. So this is most stable. That is, this is the order of stability, order of stability. Reactivity will be exactly similar to order of stability of the carbocation. Jitna jaldi carbocation banega, utna jaldi wo reaction hoga. Jitna jaldi CCl bond tootega, utna jaldi carbocation banega. Carbocation tabhi jaldi banega, jab wo carbocation stable hai और सीसीएल जल्दी तभी टूटेगा जब वो अनस्टेबल है. तो जिसका कार्बोकेटायन सबसे ज्यादा स्टेबल है, जिसका कार्बोकेटायन सबसे ज्यादा जल्दी बना, उसका सीसीएल सबसे जल्दी टूटेगा. सो दिस विल बी द ऑर्डर ऑफ रिएक्टिविटी. ओके, नाउ दिस रिएक्शन ऑफ ट्रांस टू फिनाइल वन ब्रोमो साइक्लोपेंटेन, बिग मॉलिक्यूल, वेरी बिग मॉलिक्यूल. साइक्लोपेंटेन बना दिया, वन ब्रोमो टू फिनाइल, और वो भी ट्रांस में. तो अगर ब्रोमो ऊपर है तो इधर फिनाइल पीएच फिनाइल ग्रुप नीचे है, ऐसा ट्रांस. विद अल्कोहलिक क्यूएच, मीनिंग अल्कोहलिक क्यूएच मीन्स एलिमिनेशन रिएक्शन, ई टू एलिमिनेशन. If you don't remember elimination, see lecture 24, 26, 28, ये सब lectures देखो वापस. E to elimination, यानी सीधा सीधा अगर Sedziv's rule apply करें, Sedziv's rule states that more substituted alkene is major, that is, whenever elimination takes place, halogen will go from the alpha carbon and one hydrogen will go from that beta carbon which has less H. तो ये अल्फा है और ये बीटा है, ये भी बीटा है. इस बीटा के पास दो एच है लेकिन इस बीटा के पास एक ही एच है. तो एक्चुअली हैलोजन यहां से जा गया अल्फा से, तो हाइड्रोजन यहां से जाना चाहिए बिकॉज इट हैज लेस एच. लेकिन ये वैलिड है इन असाइक्लिक कंपाउंड, साइक्लिक में ऐसा नहीं होता है. साइक्लिक कंपाउंड में ई टू एलिमिनेशन तभी फॉलो होगा, यानी हाइड्रोजन उस बीटा कार्बन से जाएगा जिसके पास लेस एच है. लेकिन ये तभी होगा जब जाने वाला ब्रोमीन या हैलोजन और जाने वाला हाइड्रोजन ट्रांस अरेंजमेंट में है. अब अगर आप देखें यहाँ ये सिस अरेंजमेंट में है, तो ये ई टू मेन प्रोडक्ट ई टू एलिमिनेशन नहीं होगा और hydrogen will go from that beta which has less H. तो ये इस तरह से बनेगा और यहाँ है आपका एक PH और H. यानी कि 1, 2, 3 3-phenyl cyclopent 1-ene. 3-phenyl cyclopent 1-ene. That is the major product. Okay, 3-phenyl cyclopent 1-ene. अब इधर आ जाते हैं, major product of following reaction. Basically, the reaction will be ilia. This is succinamide. This is succinamide. This H will go definitely and will react with this. पहले ये NK बनेगा KOH से, यहाँ K आ जाएगा. If you want, you can understand that way also. Alkaline medium में इधर एक K आ जाएगा. Okay. Now, this molecule. या तो ये halogen जाएगा या तो यहाँ से halogen जाएगा. ये halogen aromatic पे है. And this halogen is on aliphatic carbon. Now, students, who is more reactive, haloarenes or haloalkanes? Do you remember who is more reactive, haloalkenes or haloarenes? Who is more reactive, haloalkanes or haloarenes? Obviously, haloarenes are less reactive than haloalkanes. इसलिए when the reaction takes place, the halogen on the aliphatic carbon will function. The halogen on the aliphatic carbon will function. This one will not react. इसको यहीं लिख देते हैं Br. The halogen on the aliphatic carbon will function. Let me just shift a little bit here. Yeah. A little bit here. Yep. And this will go. Are we beginning? To see what's the product we are getting. Like this. खाली है क्या याद रखना है? जो हैलोजन बेंजीन पे है वो हमेशा रिएक्शन में पार्ट नहीं लेगा अगर एक एलिफैटिक हैलोजन अवेलेबल है तो. ओके, सो दीज वर गुड नंबर ऑफ गुड डाउट्स. समटाइम्स यू आर आस्किंग गुड डाउट्स. ओके, बाय बाय, सी यू, ऑल द बेस्ट, लव एंड ब्लेसिंग्स टू ऑल ऑफ यू.